Hey y'all, it's me, Cheesy Panini. In this video, I'm going to show you guys 10 ways to make Christmas trees in Terraria. I will be using silly balloon blocks and walls as the primary material, but you are free to use any blocks that you prefer. Let's begin. For the first Christmas tree, the only blocks I'll be using are echo blocks and an obsidian brick as a base for the pine tree table, which will be the trunk of the tree. For the leaves, I'm only using silly balloon walls, which are placed with spaces in between them and arranged like a triangle. Now you can use the different versions of silly balloon walls or just one depending on your preference, but I like changing it up to make this gradient effect at the center. For your reference, when working with paint, silly green balloons are the darkest and has the most contrasting shine. And silly purple balloons are the lightest and tends to have the least amount of detail or contrast, especially when it comes to light colors. Silly pink balloons are the middle ground. You can check out my color palette on my website so you can compare the colors. Now that the tree is built, it's time to decorate. Now you can go ahead and start decorating this version, but just for the purpose of demonstration, I'll be decorating a larger version of this tree. As you can see, this one also has a gradient effect, but this time it's lighter at the top and darker at the bottom. The first decoration I'll be placing is the tinsel. Those are the metallic strips you often see in Christmas trees. For me, the best block that looks the part are coral stone blocks because it imitates the texture of it nicely, especially once they're painted yellow or gray. However, if you want it to really shine, I would suggest experimenting with one of the ores instead. Next, I want to put those giant bows, and for that, I'll be using streamers in random spots of the tree. For Christmas baubles, on the other hand, I'll be using silly balloon blocks. You can also use sunflake blocks as an alternative since they're also round. And for some extra decorations, I added golden lanterns because they look pretty and I wanted to place as many items on the tree as possible. For the topper, I placed a snow pylon at the top with echo blocks as the base. Now, if you're not building in a snow biome or the biome the pylon belongs to, you can always go into T-Edit and place it there instead. To finish it off, I put presents under the tree because that's what Christmas is all about. And because of the lanterns and pylon, it lights up pretty well at night. Let's move on to our second tree. The second tree is basically just the block version of the first tree with hammered bits on the upper corners and the base trunk is made with a door instead. Now, as a general rule for trees that primarily use blocks like this one, it's difficult to decorate it as it is. You could probably only put decorations under the tree or over it, so what we do is we put spaces in between them. You can do this by separating them in T-Edit or with mods, or you can just build them at the start with spaces in between. I'm going to start with the topper this time, and I'm using silly balloons to make a giant circle one. One thing you have to know about placing blocks on top of hammered blocks is it will make those hammered blocks go back to their unhammered or original form, so you have to hammer them back. One thing you can do to avoid this is to hammer them later, but I personally don't follow that rule that much, so I just rehammered all of them. You can also avoid doing this by placing the blocks in T-Edit instead. For the spaces in between, I placed some disc walls to make it more interesting. For this tree, I wanted a thicker type of tinsel and used crimson grass walls for this and removed and hammered some blocks to create the shape. This is also where I'll be placing the Christmas baubles and ribbons. To make it light up at night, I'm also placing green lights around the blocks. And of course, don't forget the presents. Let's work on the third tree. This one is a combination of silly balloon blocks and walls, but this time, the trunk is made from actuated frozen slime blocks and the walls at the tip are palm wood fences because it's thin enough to not be bigger than the blocks, but also does not have gaps in between them. I also hammered the blocks into these zigzag shapes underneath. Just like the previous tree, we're gonna need one block spaces in between the layers for the decorations. For this tree, I'm using team blocks to make this diamond topper and some solar platforms, which I painted purple and hammered as ribbons in between the layers. I also placed streamers that I also painted purple underneath the tree. Now there's this one important trick that I learned. If you use one type of streamer to connect these, it will just make a straight line. But if you used a different type of streamer in between and just painted the same color, it will have a curve, but it won't look like it was two different streamers. Unlike the first ones, this one doesn't glow in the dark, and I think that's fine. If you're going to place this indoors, you'd probably have lights inside it anyway. So I think it's perfectly okay if not all the trees light up in the dark. Time to make the fourth tree. For this tree, I'm using a confetti cannon angled vertically for the trunk, and I'm still using the same old silly balloon, block, and wall combination for the leaves. It's also hammered in a zigzag way, but this time I included the top as well. And just so you know, these chunkier and rounder zigzags are a result of not hammering every single edge and keeping it to its original state. Time to decorate. Let's change things up a little for this one and paint it pink. I really want a girly Christmas tree this time. As I was looking through Christmas tree designs, I found out that some people like to use cotton instead of tinsel to wrap around a tree. So I'll be using cloud blocks and walls and painted it with the same paint as the tree to give it the same hue. I also put some silly balloons as baubles here as well, painting it yellow, orange, and white because it reminds me of candy. To make it even more sickeningly girly, I put silly balloon blocks at the top and hammered them into a bow as the topper. This one also doesn't glow, but that's okay because it looks fabulous! Let's hop on over to the fifth one. Guess what this tree is made of? That's right, even more silly balloon blocks! In this one, I layered it with two different alternating silly balloon blocks and hammered the edges into a slant, creating a triangle. For the trunk, I used a living wood door. Now, if you want this one to glow, since there are no gaps in between these blocks, you can simply add emerald gemspark walls behind it or diamond gemspark walls if you don't want the green glow. You can even put a little bit under here for a little bit of depth. As for decorating this tree, I could pretty much do just the same things as I did with the previous trees, but I want to change this up as well. For this one, I decided to paint each block in the different colors of the rainbow and pairing them with painted gemspark walls that also represent its closest colors. I also placed some slime platforms with matching colors to add even more detail to it, making it look more tree-like. I also changed the tree's trunk to a white sandstone door because I thought it matched better with the rest of the tree. And when you turn off all the lights, it's absolutely radiant. Now let's look at our sixth tree. This one starts off just like the previous one, but this time the trunk is a rich mahogany fence and you hammer the blocks by a half block alternatingly like so. Then you place silly balloon walls underneath to complete the look. Now we've got a couple of classic Christmas trees, a candy themed one, and a rainbow colored one, so why not make this one a beach themed one? A beach themed tree? What's that even supposed to look like, you ask? Well, once you put gaps in between the layers like this and paint it white, it kind of almost looks like a conch shell. And since it looks a lot better, I changed the rich mahogany fence to shade wood fence here as well and painted it white. For the decorations, I used different kinds of seashells and starfish. This one doesn't glow at night either though. I could actually use one of those Christmas lights for this, but I didn't want any of those colors. If there was a white or yellow light, I would probably use that for this. Let's go to lucky number 7. This one starts off like the second tree, but I'll be using the eye statue as the trunk and I'll be hammering it in this geometrical pattern. I'll slow down the time lapse for this one so you can follow along, but to make things easier, to make this shape, just think of making a diamond shape, but the lower left or lower right corner is hammered differently. And instead of using silly balloon walls this time, I'm using crystal walls with some gaps in between certain places. Now let me give you guys another quick tip. If you want to remove a wall without accidentally hammering a block, you can use any hammer and click on an empty space before dragging it to a wall. This will remove a wall, no problem. Now to decorate this tree, I changed the tip into an inverted triangle and placed a crystal candelabra. For the spaces in between, I used hive walls, silly balloons, and logic sensors. I kind of like using logic sensors here because they kind of look like flowers. To give it a little more light, I also placed chain lanterns under the tree along with some presents. And because of the crystal candelabra, it emits the bluish purple glow at night. And on to the 8th tree. For this one, I used a column statue for the trunk. I alternated two different silly balloons with the green one, which is the darkest, at the bottom. For the top part, I placed silly pink balloons at first, then replaced some of them with a couple of silly purple balloons in random positions so that some parts will look shinier than other parts. Once I'm happy with the placements, I hammer them into these leaf or diamond-like shapes which point to the center. To match the shape and theme, I used hive walls behind it and some palm wood fences at the edges to give the tree more definition. And now for some decorations. The tree itself is already kind of fancy without one, and I don't think the usual tinsel, ribbons, and baubles are gonna cut it for this type of tree. Since it's futuristic looking, we need futuristic looking decors. And what's more futuristic than Martian platforms? We just need to put them at the top, bottom, and in between and hammer them like so. One thing I learned about hammering platforms is if you hammer it at the same angle as the hammered blocks below it, it will automatically extend like that. I hammered the bottom alternatingly while the top was hammered into a V shape, so it looks like it's holding the topper, which will be made out of diamond gemspark, sapphire gemspark, and crystal blocks, which are hammered into a diamond. I also chose this color scheme because it matches the color glow of the Martian platforms at night. Let's get started on the 9th tree. This tree follows the same formula of the 4th tree, but unlike the previous trees, this one has a thicker trunk and has even thicker layers. I used palladium column wall for the trunk, snow walls in between the gaps, and silly balloon blocks for leaves. In the decoration phase, I placed some silly balloon blocks under the trees along with ice elemental banners and bamboo lanterns. One thing to take note of is that you can only place banners and lanterns in blocks that aren't hammered. As for the in-betweens, I kept the gaps but placed sunplate blocks and stardust platforms alternatingly and hammered them facing the opposite direction from the hammered blocks below them so it doesn't extend all the way through like the first one. After that, I painted the lower half of the snow walls blue to make it look like it's part of the wrap of the tree. As for the topper, I replaced the silly balloon blocks at the top with sunplate blocks and two stardust platforms by its sides. And finally, the 10th tree. Let's go! This one actually follows the rules of the pine tree I made in my video, Building Realistic Trees in Terraria, which I highly recommend if you're not into these toy trees I'm making right now. For this, I'm using living wood walls for the trunk, and just like my pine tree tutorial, you place chunks of blocks in a line above your trunk like a kebab, then start adding and removing a few blocks here and there. You can follow along the time lapse to get the exact same shape as the one you're doing over here, or you can make your own shape. Either way is fine. And after that, I started adding the silly balloon and left some gaps in between so that the space in between layers looked more detailed and busy. And if you want this to glow, you can put Jaspark walls behind the blocks at the center. And now it's time to decorate. For the top part of the tree, I placed a starfish and painted it yellow. Next, I placed some silly balloon blocks as baubles, taking care to rehammer the parts of the leaves that got deformed. Then, I placed some logic sensors, streamers, honey lanterns, and red banners all over the tree, which is all in a symmetrical pattern. And you may remember that I placed emerald Jaspark walls behind this, and maybe some of you would be confused as to why it's not glowing green anymore. The reason for that is because the honey lanterns, which glows brighter with white light, canceled out that color. And those are the 10 different ways you can make Christmas trees in Terraria. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, please do leave a like and comment down below which tree is your favorite. And if you don't want to miss any of my next uploads, please do consider subscribing. Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays! For now, I'm just gonna go do my thing and you guys do your thing, and I'll see you guys later! Take it easy, stay cheesy!